alternative, and I will probably drop this video on YouTube. There will be your voice in it, so are you okay with that?
Yeah, sure, man. You guys, fuck off.
that will also be on YouTube. Come on.
it's up to you to decide, mate. Like I don't really bother about it.
No. Imagine I become a very good player, and everyone asks me who was your trainers, and I would say Sangmars. I mean, there's a lot of people who can give you advices, but not a lot of people who knows how to give an advices. I was coaching myself, and I have met a lot of coaches that are not, like, you know, good with advices. As I'm not talking about this game. I was playing Counter-Strike a lot, and I was coaching myself, and I tried coaching myself, and I noticed the difference between good, bad, and, you know.
The combat system. What do you know of the combat system so far?
Okay, I know the left swing, the right... No, I'm kidding. Okay, the stab. I know that with the hammers, I'm better against heavy. With sword slashing, I'm better against the medium or light. What else? I concentrate mostly on two-handeds, and two-handeds I need to directional block or chamber. Directional chamber. I really like to chamber those NPCs, and I got a good practice on them. And if I get a not very good player, I can chamber him all the fight. Only chambering takes a lot of stamina, I noticed. So that's why I'm wearing the light shield to save on stamina a little bit.
Yeah, well, everything you said is correct. Heavy armor is weak against blunt weapons. So if you see someone wearing heavy, go with your blunt weapon.
Yeah.
The downside of Glory Victus is that you have to know all the certain skins, you know, like you can.
How does skin look? Right.
For example, my pointy stick here, right here, is a hammer. And for example, if you look at my character, my helmet is heavy.
Yes.
My shoulders are heavy. My chest is medium. And the rest is also medium. But that's not something which you learn in one get-go, right?
Yeah.
It's not I can teach you, you have to get to know and understand, but my advice is always start with a hammer.
Yeah.
And if you think you do around less than 90 damage to a player with your orange gear,
then it's a wrong weapon.
Then switch to a Guzarm, for example. I like a Guzarm more. It's very nice for against medium
armor. Yes, we have
so
that one
you
too.
Full medium, right?
I'm all full medium because of the stamina.
So
I like more stamina.
It's 133, and if I hit you with a hammer side swing, it's 102. That's the big difference. So if you see with a hammer, okay, I only do 100 damage, and I see on you that you have purple gear, then I might change to, for example, a Guzarm. I like the Guzarm because it deals a lot of left-right side damage. Also, overhead is pretty nice. Because if you compare it with a spear, as you understand,
a spear doesn't do
any damage.
Mm-hmm.
And a stab is easily blocked by a center block.
Yeah.
Simple as that. So that's why I would rather use a Guzarm than a spear. Spear is very nice in teamfights, especially against horses, then I would rather use them. But for duels, I would go for a hammer, a Guzarm. And I'm not very much a sword player, to be honest. It is fast. It may be one of the most, well, the fastest weapons in the game, especially the light attacks. But the general,
I got advice to use the sword against archers. It's way faster to chop them down with the sword.
But you can also use the axe.
I love axe.
And especially the overhead attacks, because the overhead attacks with the axe deal more damage than a sword.
Yeah, I noticed that axe does really a lot of damage.
Yeah, the axe deals also the most damage you can shield. So if you want to break a shield, especially if you want to go through a shield wall, then you use a axe as well to break the shield. Because breaking a shield gives you more opportunities to damage the player in front of you. So that's for me, that like the
Carlos,
basic,
you are pleb.
Why?
Arul PL from Poland,
oh,
probably.
Yeah.
All that.
don't mind him. What can I also tell you about the rest? You know there's a difference between attacks, right? So you have heavy attack and a light attack.
Yeah, if I hold longer, it's a heavy attack, right? Yeah. And if I just click it, it's a quick attack or light attack.
Exactly.
I call it quick.
Like it's doesn't really matter how you tell it. Like the left attack, less damage, less stamina consumption, and doesn't really interrupt the attack of the attacker.
Wait, pause. Left attack is less stamina consumption. Left
light
and right.
Light attack is less. No. Light attack is
light
less
attack.
Consumption.
Light attack.
Light
okay.
attack. So one click on your button.
So if I do like quick, it takes almost the same as I do powerful, right? Or no? How do I calculate that? Wait. It took 12.
It's neglectable in my honest opinion, but...
And this one took almost 20. Okay, I didn't know that. I was thinking each attack basically uses the same what it says on a sword.
Because if you hold your attack, then it also consumes a lot of stamina, especially when you faint. If
fainting.
You see that your stamina is going down rapidly. And this game doesn't really want to hold you attack like very long. In the past, there has been a meta where people were only holding like faggots all the time. That's my playstyle.
Ender Klaus. Hello. Carlos Trainer. Yes.
And that's why they reduced it. Like, but okay, light attacks. If you hold your attack for me, don't release it.
Yeah.
And if I hold, there you go. I interrupt your attack.
Yes, so, with a heavy.
Exactly. So heavy attacks interrupt the other's attack, and if you hold your attack for me, again, a light attack doesn't interrupt.
Yeah. So I can continue with my attack.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
I noticed that.
You have abilities in your ability tree, for example, like battle rage. If you go to B,
unstoppable.
I have survival instinct, for example, but if you have battle rage, some people, not a lot of people do that, but battle rage will not interrupt your attacks from time.
That's fun, that's a really cool passive, but I am a bruiser medic, so I don't have any of the top.
You are a man of culture, I see.
Ah.
So many people joining this channel right now. So
they notice that you are on my stream, or I don't know, they want some fame. Now everybody will come to this arena. Get ready.
I just want to talk. So that's the difference between light and heavy attacks, and there's nothing in between. You can see if you charge, charge attack for me.
I think if you let go even on the green one that's almost full, you still get a heavy attack, no? Like if you
like
time it, right?
I don't know how you have set your indicators on your screen. So if you hold the attack for me quickly. Oh, you don't have that.
What do I need to
have? Oh yeah, you do. Hold up, do it again. Ah, yeah. So if you hold your attack, you see like a
it turns yellow.
Up, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that yellow bar. And it's, you have to get used to it, but eventually you know like how long you have to hold your attack to get a heavy attack. So if that yellow thingy goes bright, then you have a heavy attack.
Everything it needs to light up even, right? Because if it doesn't light up, then it's still not heavy,
exactly.
Heavy enough.
Exactly.
Okay.
You can try on me for a bit. Like I will try to hold my attack, try to interrupt my attack. Yeah, that's heavy attack.
That's heavy.
Heavy attack.
That
and the the duration to swing it is it's the same all the way. What else? Keybinds. Do you have any keys keybinded or not?
I did bind everything, so I have a left, block, right, up, kick. There's my kick. Then I have attacks also, all separate buttons. Stab, and I have a faint button, so I can faint it. What else do I need? The running, and jumping.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's better than me. I'm a mouse clap. I only have overhead keybinded, step keybinded, and center block keybinded.
The
what else? What else? if I do duels, like this a general rule in my honest opinion. If you don't see a attack indicator, so if you don't see my attack indicator anymore, then don't block. Simple as that.
Okay.
What
then
I mean
I need
with
to
that
get a
is,
habit
you know
of that.
that you know that if you block and I kick you at the same time
Yes.
while you're still blocking, you get staggered.
Yeah. You notice that
you have
I have
remember,
a bad habit to block when someone wants to
yeah.
kick.
Exactly. So that's why I always give advice, and that's of course you have to practice that in arenas, etc. You cannot do anything about it. But if you don't see attack indicator, just instantly release your block. That's something which you have to practice. And what always helps for me is that I move my character a little bit over my head, so I can completely see your opponent, like from head to toe in this case.
I noticed that everybody is looking down
yeah,
when fighting. That's the reason, right?
That's because you want to see what's happening. There is a difference between attacks and when someone wants to initiate a kick. The movement is different.
Can you kick?
It's hard to see if you're newer to the game, but in my honest opinion, it really helps because if your camera is, for example, in the middle of your screen, then you do not see what's happening in front of your eyes. Yeah, you can
yes,
see the attack
I'm blocking it.
But as you know, in Gloria Victis, not everything is synced very well. So you cannot always trust the attack indicators in that scenario. So that's why you want to look a little bit downwards, not all the way down, because then you cannot see what's happening around you. But you want to see your opponent from head to toe. And don't block where you don't see an attack indicator. That's hard. That's something which
good
you have to
advice.
Practice anyway. But it is what it is. So what I now want to try to do, right, is you do not attack me. I just try to attack you, and don't try to get staggered. Yeah.
Get kicked. Okay.
Don't get kicked. And always try to move with my character. So if I try to get behind your back, this is also a thing. Try not to get staggered. Nice. Light attack in. Some people do overhead and then a left swing out at the same time, or... Nice, well done. I like your movement. I'm trying to get behind your back. And what I can do is, if I try to get behind your back, is... do a light swing like this. Because I know with a heavy attack you will just block. Nice, I was at your side, you still managed to avoid my kick. Like this is actually going very well.
Because I need to concentrate.
Never mind. I jinxed it.
I clicked the other pole. Nice. And again,
uh-oh.
You see?
Uh-oh.
Okay. Yes.
I was complimenting you, but...
Yeah, don't compliment.
Out of stamina now, I have to stem up a bit.
Okay, let's wait. That was fun. But if you would do this with me for, let's say, 10 minutes every day, I would get so good at dodging those kicks.
and the thing is, right, you can do this with everyone. It's not hard. It's not 100 HQ training. It's... just a mix between avoiding kicks, but still I feint a lot, so I try to see whether you can block still at the same time. Especially light attacks, because a lot of top players in the arena ranking tend to light attack from time to time. You're doing very well, Bekkies. Now I try to desync behind your back. How I do that, no idea, I just try to move my character in yours. And what I always try to do is go behind your sides, like at your side or behind your back, and then kick you, but you're doing... So far you're doing...
I noticed that getting enemy behind you, it's not very nice.
No. Because when I kick you... I try to get behind your back to deal more damage, backstep damage. And people try to... Well... I wouldn't say... not scared. What's the English word for that?
Fear? More fear
no,
behind?
No, not feared. I mean, they try to react and they're like, what is happening?
Yeah.
And at that moment, they try to block and I kick them and I'm like, you're fucked. It's also a little bit mental.
Ouch.
Okay, not too shabby. I'm summing up again.
Hmm. You see, when I concentrate only on one thing, maybe it's not that hard. But when I need to concentrate, let's say, block and attack you, then it might get trickier.
Exactly.
But your advice, as soon as your attack light is off,
yeah,
I should get a habit of... That's what happened. I clicked the other direction block now.
Yeah. If you don't see attack indicator, don't...
Don't block.
Don't block. Like the general rule. Okay. Still light attacks.
Light attacks doesn't kill me like a big guy like me.
I know, right? Until I use a different sword or a weapon, then
yes.
It will really matter. I mean, I like your movement. You know what I'm doing.
To be honest, I don't know what I'm doing with the movement. I'm concentrating on blocking and not letting you behind.
No, like, like I've trained a lot of people in my lifetime in Gloria Victis, and it's very, very good.
Nice. Good.
What can I expect? What else? Especially against the top players, people tend to quick faint a lot. I don't like that because of keybinds, and in my honest opinion, but I'm not going to advocate for that, is that keybind should not be better than mouse, but well.
What does it mean, quick feint, like exactly?
Well, I cannot do it, but Ender can. Is Ender here? Surely Ender is here.
I was playing against Ender a little bit. He was doing a lot of crazy shit, so... If that was something he did, yeah.
Is Ender come to Arena Club? There he is. He's listening, so he knows. He's getting summoned.
He's getting summoned, oh look.
Here's Ender Klaas. Okay, do your thingy, Ender. No, not against me, you pleb. Against the Wekis, yes.
The quick feint with try
to block him.
With a sound that doesn't make a hit, right?
Doesn't matter. Just try to block him.
Not this again.
Okay. You're not falling for his kicks, which is nice. I also always fall for his light attacks, so don't worry a little bit about it.
Hey, bam! Yes, I understood. I was playing against him one stream. He came and did a lot of how is that word? Making me look bad. No, I'm kidding. I'm a noob.
It's the Ender way. Well, what is the way to fight someone like Ender in this scenario? You know that with your... Oh, moment.
He died.
What you want to do is... do you know that with a right attack you can block both left and right attacks?
Yes.
On your...
You just hold right attack and move your mouse to block it.
I really wonder if you... This is a left, this is a right. Okay, very well. Now, you have to, yes, nice.
I basically need to look the correct direction.
Exactly. This is one way to try to counter Ender. Yeah, it's very hard to block his light attacks. So what you want to do is always, like Ender, go and fight at me, please. Attack me. I only have to worry about his kicks and his overhead when he changes to overhead.
Mm-hmm.
Because his quick feints is going from left to right, and I will still be able to block it all. I only have to worry about the overhead attacks and his kicks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one. Thank you, Ender. Thank you. You see what I mean with that?
Yeah.
Especially in outnumbered situations, so let's say you against 4, 3, maybe 2 players, try to utilize this as well.
Yes, yes, and I'm using this one instead, the middle, because
is very nice.
Because everyone usually goes with the upper or stab, so that's why I go with this and try to run away.
Because you know that every weapon has like directional attacks with where overhead, for example, is times one or times 1.1.
Yeah, a little bit more.
Exactly, which has a little bit more. For example, the axe. Deals a lot of damage when you hit the overhead attack. Same for the hammer. That's why you see a lot of people doing the overhead. Because of the more DPS you do.
Hey, tomato!
That's why I want to do the overhead and try it. And this is pretty hard because it's different than what you usually try to do. And then you still have to avoid kicks, and then you have to go back to your right block.
Look, I'm holding a block, right? And there is a yellow guidance that tells me that I just clicked block, and then it turns green until it turns white. Does my block becomes breakable or something if I hold too long?
No, it's not. If you do a perfect block is when it's at the when you just block at the right
at the
time,
perfect time,
it means that it consumes less stamina. If you hold your block all the time and it gets green, then it consumes more stamina if you block a attack from your opponent.
You hit me.
This way the game wants you to block at the last moment to make you drain
Can
less
you
stamina.
Can you hit my block? I just want to see how much stamina I lose.
Oh.
I didn't lose any stamina. Wait, one more time. And no. Okay, now I'm losing. Okay, seven stamina I'm losing for every hit you do.
No, maybe I explained it wrong then. Maybe it's
Oh, because it's wooden sword. Maybe that's why.
Maybe it depends really on your blocking. Like
I know if I block on time.
I don't know. Like if you block, you have like a blocking durability, right?
Yeah,
On my screen it's 603, I cannot see...
601?
Yeah, 601. I don't know if there's a big difference, but since I do not know it, since I really do not care about it anyway. Oh, sorry. So try to block it. If you hold it for a very long time, let's see how much it drains from your block.
Oh yeah, way more.
And then if you do a perfect block...
Almost nothing, or even... Does it possible that it gave you something?
No, well...
It should drain, but not that much, right?
I don't know. Maybe it is... When you do a perfect block, you have less delay. I don't know. Maybe that's a good question. I have no answer to that in my own screen.
I know that the perfect block is way better than the holding block, right?
Yeah, just... Maybe someone else can explain, but in general, you want to do...
In general, no one in the higher ranks of Arena blocks at all.
that is and now, in general, it all comes together, right? So you did the blocking, you try to avoid kicks, but now you have to do a duel. You know the difference between light and heavy attacks.
Yes.
If you fight a better duelist, and you know that guy has better gear, that you don't want to trade as in do light attacks.
Together, hit at the same time.
Because I know if I fight you, then I can just do light attacks because I do 72 damage. And if you hit me with your, for example, with your weapons, you will do way less damage.
67.
It's not that big of a difference, but in general, I will eventually out-trade you.
Yeah, you win. Even if we hit the same at the same time and all the time, you win.
Especially when you're having full medium gear like you, I will go with a Guzarm.
Guzarm is better.
Which will do even more damage. What we can do now is try and do the combat a little bit, where we try to combine it.
Wait, where's my wooden sword? Where did I put it?
It's right there.
There it is. It was there all the time.
Well, that's fine. I will always try to overhead and overhead to a light attack. Or I switch to the right and I try to get behind your back. I'll kick you, doesn't really work. Nice. Try to faint a little bit more, or try to hold, this is also an option. It really depends on the playstyle. Nice chamber. Nice.
I need to get a habit also when I release the kick, dodge, instantly hit.
Now it's like the basic training, the training of when your kicks comes together. Like I would always, my advice to you is always go for full charge attack first, because then I have to block your attack, because otherwise I get interrupted and that's not what I want to do. Yeah, and if you see that it doesn't really work, then try to feint into a light attack. So what I mean is heavy. And right attack after, light attack after. But if you faint too much like that, it's also for me the opportunity to think, okay, you're fainting too much, I will just try to gamble you. Because it's not my initiative to attack you, but I still try to gamble and try to light or heavy attack you, since I know that I have better gear and I will damage you more than you will do me, for example.
Yeah. You said stamina?
Yeah, I was out of stamina.
And I see you walking slowly, this restores stamina at the same speed as standing still, right?
Now if you walk and press caps lock, well, for me it's caps lock.
Yeah, the walking.
I will regen stamina the fastest way. What I always tend to do is, when I start a duel, always do heavy attacks and see whether my opponent will try to attack you. Well, I still have the initiative. It's called holding, simple as that. If the player doesn't really fall for that, I try to switch and try to get behind people back. Then I will check whether you will follow my character, whether you can avoid my attacks in your back or not. And if that does not work, I will try to combine it and I will do some overhead into right attacks, like that.
I was letting it go. No! Oh, come on.
Takeys, hello? Hello?
I'm here.
Where did all the training go?
It goes away and comes in.
Nice. Good feints. I'm not someone who kicks a lot, but you can always try. But do not kick
Kicking
me,
you? It's impossible. I think it's
depends.
A waste of stamina kicking you.
It depends, but always try to test your opponent, because if you kick, it also opens for me to attack you. Like for me, it really doesn't work. Not all the time, let me say like that. Doesn't really matter that it will work from... thank you, Ender. There you go. Block me, nice.
No, that was wrong kicking.
Anything besides that, I can intentionally miss my attack. Fuck off.
Ah.
And I
Someone's helping
attack
me.
Straight after, and I most likely still have the initiative. So if you try to attack me after this one, like bang, miss, and try to attack you after.
I see.
It's also an option. It's not very viable because most of the time you will trade. But it can be nice if someone is very low and you want to.
No, I need to use this.
Then you can pull that off. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Or what you can do is like the range distance gamble, I would say. There you go. Walk away. I always tend to press R, that's auto run when I'm dueling. So after movement speed.
Wait, auto run?
Yeah. For me, it's R.
Oh, so you want your character to walk automatically all the time?
Well, that's for me, like, I would like that, because...
damn, that's crazy.
Especially when I want to run away, so if I attack you and I turn away my back and I want to auto-run, because I don't want to make mistakes, because I, well, fat finger shift, for example, too much, stuff like that.
Arul said Carlos is easy to kick. Well, not for me. Hi. Can we do this some other time? I must go. I need to pick up my kids from school.
Yeah, don't worry, man.
Yes, this was really fun, really informative. Cheese. Someone told me that it should be easy. To the left. Does every NPC is easy to cheese like that? Like there. No. Oh, then he instantly goes. Don't go too far away. Yeah, if you go there, he run. And it works with everyone? Oh, so do 360. That's why they do 360. Yeah. Oh, so that's why everyone's basically doing those 360s. They kind of got a habit from playing with the champions, right? Yeah.
We will move on again.
Yeah. Thank you. That was really, really good. Better than, better than any video you can find there.
Well, hopefully he will improve now, Wiggish. Hopefully we will find you on the battlefield now.
At least dodging those kicks would be amazing to do now. Yeah, thank you very much. See you next time.